3 second call. And checking into the basketball game now, Jay Locklear, big 6'11 sophomore. The boundaries of recruiting for Charlie Coles are expanding, Greg. Rock Hill, South Carolina to get Jay Locklear.
Not bad. It's been a two-man show for the Redhawks in the second half.
And they have all 24 that Miami has put in the book as Wally Zerbiak sits down. Will it be for the night? That triple's going to go down from the gun of Deshaun Hadley. So Hadley, a young man that hasn't been able to get off tonight, shooting the basketball a little bit better for Milton Barnes, drains that three. Mestis. Give Frierson a look from the baseline and ring it up. Damon Frierson, nothing in the first half, has 14 here in the second half.
I think he acquits us very well. Remember, we gave him a little pub in our open.
Yes, we did.
And he's showing why now.
Oh, it's well deserved. He's a deluxe talent. Inside 6 minutes on this Eastern Michigan trip. Urquhart showed it on Locklear. And we've got a whistle. That is with a stop to it as Jason Stewart got into the bush. Let's talk about this Miami ball club. Obviously, they have all the components, Greg. They're on their way to going to 5-0 here tonight. And Charlie Coles is no stranger to the pressure of the month of March in tournament time and NCAA tournament time.
No question about it. But this team, you know, they're going to see some very, very tough nights, and they're going to have to find a way to get it done, even on nights when they're struggling.
Uh-huh.
Because when you're the best team, you're undefeated. Everybody's gunning for you. Everybody wants to put that one on the loser side. But I think this is a team that can handle it. Now, they've lost three games all on the road. They have not lost at home. But they're going to have to improve and keep improving so that they can be the very best that they can possibly be come March. I think they're well on their way right now.
Right. They seem to have that mental toughness about them.
Yeah.
Going away. We talked about Wally Zerbiak was talking about that with us, about keeping your boys away from home and being able to play in front of, shall we say, a less than favorable crowds.
Here's the attempt at penetration that time by Larry Fisher. It's up about non-shooting variety. I like Miami. They got a lot of pieces to the puzzle in place. You know, they defend well. They play well together. And each guy seems to understand and accept his role.
I think you hit on the big plus, right? They defend well and kind of bring that lunch bucket mentality as that three's going to go down on the gun of Larry Fisher. Deep three for young Larry Fisher.
You noticed. And he had to be a good 4 or 5 feet behind the line that time.
Oh, look at Rob Mestis, Greg. He showed us everything in his repertoire there. Took it down to his hip and then used the window to spin it home.
I think just looking at that play and seeing how he finished gives you an indication of how unselfish he is and how seriously he takes his role as a distributor. He got to the basket with ease, but he hasn't been doing that a lot in this game, settling to get everybody else points and keep the floor balanced. Look at Larry Fisher. I mean, this is from downtown, way downtown. Gets it to go. Unfortunately, Greece to Michigan, it just hasn't been enough of that.
They hit a little bit of run when they took that lead in the first half with that big 18-0 blitz. Sort of not Wally Zerbiak. We wonder whether we'd see him back again with underneath 5 minutes to go. But Charlie Coles got him the quick blow and then got him back in the basketball game. Can't imagine it's too pleasant for Coles when he's got Zerbiak sitting next to him. Wally's probably telling him, get me back in the fray soon.
Well, you know, clearly Zerbiak doesn't play for personal numbers. But, you know, he's a top player. And in order to get that All-American status that he wants at the end of the year that everybody predicts for him at the beginning of the year, well, he's got to keep those numbers up there. But I think if you watch him, you clearly see that his importance really goes beyond the numbers. If he only scored 10 points tonight, it would have been clear to see how much he means to this team.
Now, Wally Zerbiak, almost ironically, the last three games he's played against Eastern Michigan, 26 points in each of the three. And he's sitting on 25 as we speak. Larry Fisher did not get the roll on that deep three.